IUI, we know what is IUI. This is the deposition of processed hydrogen gas forms. Before start thinking of doing IUI, this thing, a new draft bill is waiting for us. According to this draft bill, they have categorized various fertility centers into various categories. It can be primary, which can be 1A, which is carrying only preliminary investigation on fertility, engaged in IUI process, CIIM, which is done in a other center. The procedural process is done in another center. Number B, do the CIIM preparation in your center, and you have to register this center with ICMR. Secondly, is level 2 is engaging in CIIM interaction by electrical regulation, CIIM preparation, cost test, particular quantity, and combined medical surgical treatment by a specialist team. You also need to be registered. And level 3 is preparing IUI, IDI production, it has to be registered. What I am trying to say is, you are preparing single sample in your center, you have to be registered with ICMR. The next is PCPNA Act. It is a central act. All IUI procedure degrees have to be registered with PCPNA, and all clinics with ultrasound machine need the mandatory registration of PCPNA. It is a central act, but the interpretation of this act is different in different states. Not only in different state, even in different district. Different district in Delhi, they have a different interpretation. Some districts say you have to send, fill up this form, send to us. Some district says there is no need. So we also don't know. So you have to follow whatever is the local PCPNA is saying. If you are trying to set up an IUI center in your, you are all gynecologists, you want to set up an IUI lab, it needs personnel to run the center, it needs certain infrastructure, and it needs certain equipment. It is not expensive affair. If you look at it in your own any practice, you can set up an IUI center for around 3 to 4 lakhs. What is the essential factor that makes a difference? What is the ideal, what is physical, and what is what are the personnel we need? We need a basically a gynecologist. According to ICMR draft, we should be postgraduate degree diploma holder. Next one. And the responsibility of gynecologist is improving infertile couple, decision-making, recommending appropriate tests, carrying out endoscopy, ultrasound, and he should be capable of performing IUI or artificial insemination. There has been no conversation. Besides gynecologist, you need an embryologist. Embryologist who should be familiar with ARP, and he has to be medical graduate with a postgraduate degree or doctor in appropriate area of life sciences. Basically, the embryologist should be able to know in principle and practice of semen analysis and cryopreservation of semen. And he should ensure that all the necessary equipment are present in the laboratory and are functional. You may need a counselor. According to ICMR guidelines, all fertility clinics should have a counselor, and he should be preferably a postgraduate degree in psychology. And in case you don't have a counselor available, qualified counselor available, any member of the staff who is not engaged in any other field activity can also act as a counselor. But you need to have a counselor in future. What are the infrastructure? You have a certain non-stride area for the center, and some stride area. This is a rough pragmatic diagram of what should be an IUI center look like. We have a waiting area, consultation room, we have a signal collection room, and finally you have a IUI room where you perform the procedure, and IUI lab. This is how the reception and waiting room should be near to the consultation room, should have a good ambience, and you should have a patient-friendly atmosphere. And a consultation room, privacy should be maintained, and ultrasound room should be very nearby, and you should have built in a separate reservation room for weight and immunization. The non-stride area, you need a general purpose laboratory which most of the centers, nursing homes are having. You need a store room to stock all these natural items. You need a report room, you should be prepared with computerized. And you need a particular room for sterilizing and autoclaving. And step for warming to fill should be taken to make the whole area warming to be suitable traps. And you need a separate semen collection room. You should be well prepared with privacy and an appropriate environment located in a secluded area close to the laboratory and should be in house. The procedure of semen collection, we all know, should be in a sterile white bottle. And you must have a wash basin with the soap and toilet, and must have a toilet which is not used for other purposes. Advertising, in my experience, most of the nursing homes, most of the places who do anyway, they are using their toilet as a semen collection room, which is not proper. You should have a separate semen collection room with an appropriate environment. That is how a husband can produce a sample. IVF room, it must be a separate clean room for IVF procedure with an appropriate table. Well, you cannot be performing IVF procedure on the same table we are performing deliveries. It has to be a separate clean room. The sterile area is the IVF lab where you process the semen. It must be a separate room with an embryo airflow and preferably close to the semen collection room. The care should be taken for safe disposal of biological waste and other materials. We have to be careful. In Delhi, I'm very sure in Chennai also, they have different color of baskets available where you throw the disposal, the biological waste, which is removed every day. IVF lab area should be around 100 square feet. And it is preferable to have the laboratory adjacent or near to the IVF room so that once the sample is prepared, you can pass through a window and you can do the procedure of insemination. It is important to have a falling precaution. All the electrical wiring should be concealed. It is better to avoid a false setting in the IVF center or IVF lab. Split or central air conditioning is preferable to a window air conditioning. And the laboratory should not get contaminated when AC is being serviced. The floor should be covered with large marble tiles of the night area or one can always prepare to throw the vitrified tiles. The better to have a clean floor. And similarly, the walls should also be clean. The walls can be also covered with tiles or you can use epoxy paint. Not the general routine paint, epoxy paint has no smell. And if you want to boost it and are planning that in future you will throw it into the IVF lab, you can always use pressure body to create positive pressure in the laboratory. However, this is not a must if you are only planning to IVF. Ultraviolet, for studying in the IVF lab, you need to have ultraviolet lab, ultraviolet light, and you have to have the switch on or button outside the lab so that once you enter the lab, you can switch off. You should not work with the ultraviolet light. And it is enough that you can turn on ultraviolet light on the weekend when there is no work in the lab. The requirement of the equipment essentially is a centrifuge, a laminar air flow, trinocular, binocular microscope, dry incubator, test tube warmer, refrigerator. The desirables are phase contrast microscope, macular chambers, UV incubator, grab can, experimental is CASA. From pumping chamber, we have an IVF center, so we are using macular chamber. If we are not using macular chamber, you can make use of the simple newer chamber also for sperm pumping. Optionally, the CASA, which is used to be used in lab with a large volume of work on simulacrum. However, it is not required to run a routine IVF laboratory. Microscope, you basically need a binocular microscope, preferably phase contrast to test the semen common motility morphology. And the microscope should have 10x, 20x, 40x, 100x objectives. You need a centrifuge, you should have a timer and rotor, up to 2000 RPM. Most of the clinics are using Remy, or now pump which is also available, which has a temperature control in it. Or then you need one dry incubator, which is set at 37 degrees, which can probably be basically Siemens connection there. Or you can simply use a digital heater also, whose surface temperature is set at 37 degrees centigrade. One dry incubator costs around 25,000 rupees. Carbon dioxide incubator is optional. If you are using bicarbonate, copper media, it is important to use a bicarbonate incubator. If you are using aqueous media, you can simply use the dry incubator instead of the steam incubator. This is a digital heater available. There is no need to have incubator, dry or silicone. You can simply use a digital heater as an alternative to the incubators. And it is cheaper and gives you equivalent results. You can have a laminar flow, but you can have either vertical or horizontal laminar flow. Vertical laminar flow is less harmful to the lab worker. On the other hand, horizontal is more effective in reducing contamination. You don't need to have a big size, 4x2, which is a standard size, or 6x2. You can have a smaller laminar flow for the IUI lab. It is preferable to ask for a stainless steel top as it is durable and easier to clean. Nowadays you can order laminar flows with your top, it is digitally by liters to maintain 37 degree temperature. This is how the endology lab looks. Because it is part of IUI center, that is why it is looking like this. If we have only IUI center in your hospital, in your clinic, it may not be looking like this, but what it is a laminar flow. And the dry incubator on the right side, we have a centrifugal machine. All these are essential for an IUI lab. Culture media, you can have. Previously, people used to manufacture their own media, but now they are having ready-made media available to us. They are easily available and they are testing for toxicity. And they can be simple, they can be simply herpes, simply work for culture media, which can be balanced out solution or human fluid media or complex solution like amlodipine. And some of the companies supplement the media with phenolate, which is helpful in regulating pH of the media. Aqueous molecule in the media maintain pH between 7.2 to 7.4 when exposed to the atmosphere. So these media, they don't need dedicated 5% CO2 incubator to maintain pH. The bicarbonate based media, you need to have CO2 incubator, because the bicarbonate molecules are there, so you need 5% carbon dioxide atmosphere. In recent time, it has been shown that with a 6% CO2 mixture is better than 5% to maintain pH between 7.2 to 7.4. But like I said, if you are using aqueous media, you don't need CO2 incubator. The culture media, bicarbonate media is useful for maintaining long-term culture conditions, which are needed for IUI. For short-term procedure like simon washing and processing, they are not essential. So for simon wash procedure, done for intra-human insemination, hippie buffer media along with use a simple digital heater or dry incubator is adequate for any post-wash simon samples. These are the various disposables required in an IUI center. You have simon collection container, you have a 14mm conical and long bottom tube, bachelor paper, IUI cannula, penicillin, dry oils, powder free gloves, and ethanol alcohol for cleaning the lab. This is again the same conical tube, round bottom tube, the cement collection. Consumables are media. It is mandatory that single use disposable consumables are used. Reagent, media, and consumables should always be used prior to the expiry date. You have to have somebody responsible who can check for the expiry date. The size of bottle and other packing must be appropriate to minimize the opening and time between the first and last day. Don't buy 100 ml media. You are going to use 4 ml today and 4 ml after 2 weeks. So the more time you open it, you will get contamination. Repeated shift of temperature should be avoided by handling in your pocket. In conclusion, the success of the IUI program depends upon the expert hand. Clean environment, proper instrument disposable media, standard protocol, and quality control. as a gynecologist, you have to remember that IUI lab has to be a separate entity in the center. It cannot be a part of your same delivery room or this thing. It has to be separate. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Nayar. May I please request Dr. Nayar to give us more token of appreciation. We have another.